comparison of EMFs of two cells using a potentiometer. So, a potentiometer consists of a uniform wire of length maybe 1 meter or 4 meter or 10 meter. A potentiometer wire with a length of 10 meter is more sensitive. So, ends of the potentiometer wire AB in the diagram. So, they are connected in series with a battery and a plug key. This is battery, this is plug key. So, this part of the circuit we call it as primary circuit. So, this primary circuit will establish potential gradient over the wire AB. Then, in the secondary circuit, the cell of EMF E1 is connected. Let's say there are two cells of EMFs E1 and E2 to be compared. So, first I will connect the first cell E1. Then, I will connect it this way so that positive of battery is connected to A, positive of this cell is also connected to A. So, this is secondary circuit. Now, from the negative of the cell, galvanometer is connected, galvanometer to sliding contact. This can be moved over the wire AB. Now, the sliding contact is held at A and moved towards B. At some point C, that is how we get balance condition. So, balance condition means galvanometer shows zero. That means the EMF of the cell matches with potential difference across the length AC of the wire. So, potential difference across length AC of the wire is proportional to length. So, EMF E1 should be proportional to L1, or if potential gradient on the wire is some phi, then E1 is equal to potential gradient phi into L1. Let us call this as equation 1. Now, we will replace E1 by E2. Let us say this is E2, this is L2. Now, the same thing is repeated. Same thing is repeated by connecting E2 at the place of E1. Then you will get a different balancing length, L2. So, what we had here is E1 is equal to phi into L1. Similarly, here we get E2 is equal to phi into L2. This is equation 1. This is equation 2. Divide the both. What we get is E1 by E2 is equal to L1 by L2. Notice one thing. More is the balancing length, more is the EMF. So, E1 by E2 is equal to L1 by L2. So, by this, we can compare the two EMFs. Compare the EMFs of two cells by using potentiometer. Out of these two, suppose if one of the EMFs is known, let us say E2 is known or E1 is known, then by comparing the EMFs, we can calculate the EMF of other cell. If one of the EMF is known, you can also calculate the EMF of the other cell. This is how potentiometer can be used to compare the EMFs of two cells.